I have the power. I have the power? Can I have the power, please? Whee!
So if you recall from way back when I interviewed Eva Lynn, one thing I really, really wanted them to do was to paint her in her 2002 series kind of a color scheme. You know, the pale skin, the dark purple and black kind of armor, if you will. That's just one thing I really, really wanted. Well, I was excited to hear of Battleground Eva Lynn. That's exactly what I wanted. And there's some tape, so I guess I better cut that off. Scooter back out of the way so I don't mess things up. But we got tissue paper, as always. And inside, we have our Battleground Eva Lynn. And that just looks... Oh, it comes with a cape, too. Oh, it's the toy that keeps on giving. It comes with a freaking cape. Oh, that has me excited like you don't know. I actually tried to make a cape for her once out of, I think it was like Mephisto from Marvel Legends or something. Maybe like a little skirt. I have no idea. But this thing looks great, and she's going to fall over. So we're going to let her fall. This thing looks great in packaging. And I really, really do like it. You can see this is the Evil Witch of Eternia. I don't have the original packaging from my old Eva Lynn, so I don't know if the bio's any different. I know her name was Evelyn Morgan Powers in the old one. It may be the same bio, but in case it's not, you can check that out and see. One thing I don't really remember is that find a new life with her long-lost child, the son of Skeletor. I haven't heard that before, so maybe that's something new they've added. I probably should look at the old video and try to see if I've actually showed the bio in it. I honestly don't remember. But without further ado, let's go ahead and take her out of packaging. I think that's the best thing I probably should do. I probably should do that. I think that's a good idea. You think it's good? I think it's a good idea. Let's take her out of packaging. We get her open up, and here is Evelyn out of packaging. I really like these colors a whole lot more. Nothing against the vintage figure. I think it looks great. I really do. It captures that whole look of the original. But the first time I got into He-Man, it was in the 2002 series. So this is kind of what I remember from Eva Lynn. Her accessories include her scepter, which the original, it came with... I want to say it came with both a short and a long version. I have the accessories packed away, so it's hard to go through them all and find the right things. And you can switch out the bits. Wow, a lot of stuff in there. But see, she has this nice little short one. So it comes with only the long piece, and you can switch those out. I'm not going to air everybody down, but she comes with two bits here. You can have one that actually has some paint problems all on it. And I'm all over the place in this video, but let's see if I can get rid of that, some of that paint. I don't think I can. But you can see you have the not really clear, but really loose there. The clear sphere, if you do want, or you can pop that off if I can actually get a grip on it, which I don't think I really can because it's on there really, really tight. And I'm kind of worried about bending the actual staff. There we go. And you can take on this new one that has a purple bit on it. Depending on which one you do want. I think I kind of like that one a little bit more just because it has as little contrast instead of just having the white on the metal. It does add some little contrast, but they are both pretty warped. But you can take those and, of course, pop them in her little hands just like that, which does look nice. Of course, she does come with an alternate head with her helmet on, which I really like that overall deep black. It has a really nice kind of a finish to it that's really, really reflective, and it just looks great. Just give me a little comparison real quick. See how they look together. Yeah. If you do want to. There you go. Yeah. He said a little bit more. But I think let's just go and grab the head. And I'm worried about breaking her little neck peg. It's a lot thinner than the others. Of course, it's the female peg. I'm terrified it's going to snap. You can pull her cape off if you really do want to. I like having the cape on. I think it just looks better with the cape. And you can pop the new head on. Just like that. And there you go. There's Eva Lynn. With her cape and her new head. Yeah, looks great. Now, one major difference that I'm seeing is that her hand. The original one has two hands made for holding her accessories. Her knife and her scepter, or staff, whichever you want to call it. The new one has one hand opened. So you can only have one accessory at a time posed. One theory I have that I have not tried out yet. I kind of just thought as I was opening her up. Of course, you can have her kind of like she's casting a spell if you do want. But I do wonder, if you take Daddy Faceless here, and get him standing at least, take his little ram charm, and I wonder if she can actually hold that in her hands. Because her fingers are really rubbery, and it makes you kind of wonder if they're made for holding the ram's head. which, I don't know. It kind of works. It's in there really, really loosely. The whole thing with this is, you know, it makes sense because she didn't steal this from her father to give to Skeletor. So I wouldn't mind if you can actually hold it in her hand as if she's, you know, stealing it from him, you know, just like that. But it's a really loose fit, but it can work, and it does look okay. It does fall out rather easily, though. But, you know, nice little thing. Their colors go fantastically together. I really like how they both look, even though it's making my light freak out. I really do like that overall look, and I think they look fantastic. Let's get rid of him. And just for the sake of a comparison, let's take their old knife, or her new knife. Put it in there, so you can compare both of them together. You know, there you go. One thing I like about this one especially, there's a lot more painted details. This one, you basically have dark blue, light blue, a little metallic blue. This one, you have silvers, you have purple, you have black. You have this kind of a hot pink kind of look. There's a lot of detail thrown in. Like, all the little rivets, I guess the rivets on the knife are actually painted in. And it just looks a whole lot better in my personal opinion. I really like this one a whole lot more. For comparison, of course, real quick, to show you how they look together, I thought it would be fair. Ashy, of course, falls over, but here's the Bonehead. And they both look really nice with him. This one, of course, goes with the whole vintage look of Skeletor, but this one, the purples match his really well, and they do look fine together. I have no problem displaying this Evil-Un with that Skeletor, and I do still wish he had a cape of some kind. It's just a personal nitpick of mine. But I do think they look great together, and I may actually sell this one off now. This one, did come with the purple repaint of Zor, and this one, it doesn't have that, but it does have, you know, the alternate head, the cape, you know, just a few more accessories that the original didn't have. I'm going to knock them all down. I'm going to do it because I don't care. Articulation, of course, for these. It is the standard Masters Universe Classics body. I'm, of course, bumping everything that I can because I'm clumsy. But the arm, of course, can rotate at the shoulder area. And you've got swing out the side pretty nice and far. Really nice and far, actually. That's quite a bit. Rotates above the elbow, bends at the elbow. The wrist can rotate. You can see what I meant by this hand being kind of rubbery. It's just really bendable. The head has that full movement. The collar does kind of limit how high you can pose her head. It kind of snaps back kind of quickly because of this overall collar. But there's some silver paint on her helmet too. So there are some paint blotches on this one that I am noticing. But all the pose build is still there. I think she has an ab crunch. It's just, it's really hard to tell with her armor getting in the way. But waist can rotate. The legs can go forward, they can swing back. Really nice and far movement, even for these figures. Check out the sides, nice and wide. Rotates at the hip area, bends at the knee, rotates at the boots. Ankles can move, but they're really, really tight. So there's that. And yeah, there's Evil-Un, or Battleground Evil-Un. And, you know, I really, really like her. If you have the original Evil-Un, if you like that one, perfectly fine. Of course, there's no problem to get this one. But if you're like me, you always like the 2002 version a bit more. I would recommend picking it up without a shadow of a doubt. It is sold at Thermatic Collector, which isn't really a surprise. But if you can track it down on eBay, Big Bad Toy Store, what have you, I would say pick it up. It is a nice-looking figure. And it just looks great for your overall collection. I really like these 2002 influences on these figures. It just works really, really well for me. And yeah, couldn't like it anymore. So that's all I can really say. I'm knocking her all over the place. I'm like Chris Brown. Hope you guys have a great day and I will see you around. Take care. Wait. Don't go yet. I actually learned something. When I turned off my lamp and I pretty much finished the video, I was going to go edit it. And I realized that there's a feature I didn't know about this little orb here. If you actually put it in the light, which I'm going to get it charged for you real quick, and you already know what it means when I'm saying I'm charging it. That's a given. But I'm going to put it there. Kill that. Kill that. It actually glows in the dark, which I should have known from that kind of white paint used, but let's go ahead and take this off real quick. Plop that on there. Give it another quick charge. And there you go. So, I don't know. This is a pretty cool little gimmick you can have for it. I think I still like the purple one a bit more. But it is kind of cool that it can glow in the dark. I thought it was worth showing off because I didn't know it glowed in the dark. I had absolutely no idea. So, I am glad I saw it. I'm glad I caught it before I actually started getting the video edited. But there you go. Turn that back on. And then turn that back on. So, yeah. Again, I recommend picking it up. I do like it. It does look pretty cool. Having it at night. May have to pose next to Scareglow and see what happens. But yeah, there you go. Sorry, made a mistake. I do it sometimes. Can't really help it. I'm dumb. Okay. Bye.